what's the key to ensuring your fund board is as effective as possible when it comes to cybersecurity? Recently, I got some advice at ICI's latest cybersecurity conference.
Cybersecurity is such a wide area of expertise, and boards are just starting to become more aware of cybersecurity as a risk to the firm, be it in the operational risk, be it in the technology risk area. The boards are really evolving their understanding, and so I think one of the key takeaways from the panel was really about educating the board. How do we as cybersecurity experts better educate the board so that they can ask more relevant questions of us, so it becomes this sort of feedback loop? And I think, you know, over time, boards are starting to ask cybersecurity experts to present at a quarterly meeting, maybe annually. I think the ask is becoming more and more. So that continual education and that evolution of reporting has become really topical.
So how do you get to the Goldilocks amount of information? Not too much and not too little.
Yeah, because boards still need to remain fairly independent, I think, and you know, have that governance and oversight kind of role. They don't want to get into the operational detail of it. They don't want to be part of the incident response program. They don't want to be day-to-day managing the firm, the underlying management company. So giving them operational metrics, you know, how many patches did we roll out this month? How many phishing attacks did we have? Maybe too much information for the boards, and they may not be able to digest it enough. But we need to be able to give them more kind of risk-based metrics, I think, and you know, what are the risks to the firm? What's our ability to effectively manage money for our clients and those kinds of things? How can we get them comfortable by giving them more of that higher level metrics and reporting?
Another big question in the industry right now, and one that you all discussed, is whether or not boards need to bring on a specific cybersecurity expert.
Yeah, and that was a great topic of conversation for the board there, and I think the general consensus from the panel through the chief compliance officer, the member of the board that we had, and the other chief information security officer was that at this time it's probably not the best idea to have a specific cybersecurity expert on the board, because then you'd need to balance that with having an operational risk component or a financial risk component or member on the board. At the moment, it's really our job as presenters to those boards to educate them, bring them up to speed on these particular topic areas without having an expert on the board themselves.
So it's interesting to realize that it's just that this issue is new, but that it resembles so many others in the industry where there is a way to bring this into the board without putting an expert in cybersecurity on the board.
Yeah, that's right. And I think it's new for a lot of the regulators. It's a very hot topic in the press. X company getting hacked makes great headlines. It's a great soundbite for, you know, news reporters, and it's good conversation around the water cooler at the office. So I think, you know, people tend to be very interested in the subject matter expert, and I think that's coming through in some of the questions we're starting to get from the less technical folk at the board, because it's an unknown quantity. They need to know more about it. We need to get better about educating them, but without putting that expert on the board themselves.